I will tell you the secret setting in this higher mini split air conditioner display, but before that, let me tell you the backstory of why the customer gave this motherboard to me to get fixed. The customer complained that the display of this circuit board is not fine. He told me that this was a new circuit board that he bought. The circuit board is the same as the old one he had. The company's service center had given him the same circuit board. And the customer is now upset after buying this new circuit board. I will turn it on to show you the problem with it. It is turned on by pressing the on and off button on the remote. The display shows a 34 degree temperature, which is the actual room temperature of the room. Right now the remote is set to dry mode. The display should also be in dry mode. The indication of the dry mode is this one. But right now the display is set on heat mode. I will set the display on cool mode now. It shows the 16 degree set temperature. After a few seconds, it shows the actual room temperature. But I have set the remote on cool mode as you saw. But the display is still set on heat mode. The upper light indication is for the cool mode. This light indication is for health function. I will press the health button on the remote. As I press the health button on the remote, I heard the switching sound from the circuit board. This is the switching relay for the health function. However, the display does not show the indication for the health function. The display is stuck on heat mode. And indicating only the heat mode. This is the problem that I am going to fix, and its secret setting is also related to this fix. This circuit board is used in 1.5 ton unit. I have another circuit board which is used in different models of higher air conditioners. The displays of both circuit boards are different too. I will try to exchange these displays with one another. For exchanging the displays with one another, the circuit board has some settings in it. You will use these settings in all the circuit boards of the higher air conditioner. The model is written here on the circuit board. And the display is written above the model. We need to do these jumper settings through which we can exchange and set the display. I will explain to you in detail how to do it. The setting could vary in the circuit board model by model, so always do this setting carefully. This circuit board has only two jumper wires and with it dip switch is installed. Now I have another circuit board, which is used in a different higher air conditioner model. This circuit board has this display installed in it, which is the same as the one I am fixing. They have no difference in them. Both these circuit boards are the same. But have different displays. This circuit board has no display written on it. But the display is written on this circuit board, model is written on the top. Now to exchange these displays you will need to know about its connector. You can see some numbers are written on the connector. Which are IR, SCK, RCK, and as we move on COM1 is written on the top. And then check the color coding of the wires. This connector has red, black, yellow, green, blue, purple, brown, and white wires. After this looked at the red wire is installed with the IR and the white wire with the COM1. I will check the connector of this other circuit board. The numbering on this connector is different, let me show you how. The number of the pins on this connector is written as IR, SCK, RCK, and at the end is COM3. The white wire is the IR, as according to me IR is written first. The SCK is brown. RCK is purple. Then blue, green, yellow, black, and at the end the COM3 wire is red. Now, I will try to attach this display to this circuit board. First of all, I don't know in which position to attach the connector of the display in this motherboard, but as I have multiple circuit boards, this is why I am able to do it. Now I will attach the connector with the female connector in the motherboard. After attaching the connector on this side, the white wire is attached to the IR pin, and the COM1 with the red wire. The connector is attached in reverse configuration to its wires. I will reverse the connector. Now the red wire is attached with the IR and the white wire with the COM. I have passed electricity through the motherboard. The display is not turning on at all with the remote. I have connected the connector according to this other display connector. I will reverse the position of the connector again, where I attached it first. The IR pin is attached to the white wire and the COM with the red wire again. Now I will pass the electricity through it. The display has turned on, and it is showing an E1 error code. I will attach the thermistor to the motherboard. After attaching the thermistor, the display does not show any error. The display has now turned on with the remote too. I will turn it off and then turn it on. The display is showing 16 degrees, which is set on dry mode. I have set the display on cool mode at 19 degrees. Now I will set it to heat mode. The light has turned purple after changing the mode to heat, which means that this display is working absolutely fine with this motherboard. The display wire is loose connection, which is why the display digits were fluctuating. The next setting is to set the display according to this chart on the motherboard. J1 and J2 are written over here on this chart. Then the numbers 387, 325, 498, 324, and 317 are written over here. The J1 and the J2 is jumper setting. These numbers are the model numbers of the displays. To attach the display, you will have to configure it according to this motherboard setting. Then the display will work fine. As this display had worked on this motherboard. Now I will open this display cover to find its model number and check why it worked on this motherboard. I have opened the cover and will take this display circuit out of it. The display model numbers are written in two different ways. A sticker is attached from the company. The last digits on this sticker are 387. Other than this, if this sticker is not pasted, then the permanent number is also written on the display. 387 is written here too. You will have to find what code is written on your display. And then you have to set it according to the chart given on the motherboard. Both the two jumpers for display 387 are turned on. The rest of the jumpers 40, 41, and 42 are also on. This means the C number setting is applied right now to these three jumpers. That is why the 387 display is working in this motherboard. If the display does not work, we can try out a different setting to make it work. I have removed the silicon from the dip switch on another motherboard. I will tell you how the setting will be applied to this motherboard. All the dip switches are in the off position. I will check the number of the display, which is brought to us for fixing by the customer. I will remove the display circuit from inside its cover. I have removed the circuit board. You can see a sticker is pasted on this display circuit as well. The last digits are 317F. The same if you see the permanent number on the display, the last numbers here are also 317. This means the jumper setting on the motherboard will be applied of 317. The last setting is for the 317 display, where both the jumper 9 and 24 are disconnected. If we have a look at the dip switch setting, all are in the off position. So let's check through the chart, which is off. The third and fourth dip switches have the B setting applied. The 1 and 2 number dip switches are not used at all. That is why all the dip switches are in the off position. That is why this display is working on this motherboard. As we know, this is a 317 display. So now I will attach this display according to the motherboard which the customer gave me to get fixed. This motherboard is new, so the display jumper setting needed to be set according to the motherboard. The jumper 1 and 2 will be off. I will cut these two jumpers. Then I will try all these rest of the jumper settings on the big chart one by one. When the jumper setting meets the setting of the display will start working fine. I already have this same motherboard, which has a 317 display. All these jumpers are not connected with one another. This means the B number setting is applied to these jumpers. I have attached the display to this motherboard to check does it works fine on these jumper settings. I have passed electricity through the motherboard. The display has turned on. The display is working in cool mode at a 16 degree temperature. I will change the display setting on different modes to confirm whether it works fine or not. I will first turn it off. Now I have turned it on. I have put it on cool mode now. Now I have put it on heat mode. The dry mode is also working fine on the display. I will press the health button on the remote. The health light on the display has started to glow. This means the display is working absolutely fine on these jumper settings. So it means I have to just cut all these jumpers and the display will work properly on this new motherboard. And the problem will be solved. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.